Joining us now, Barry Corbett, the Christchurch City Councilor. Mr. Corbett, since 24 hours when we last talked to you, you've probably had an opportunity to survey the damage. What have you seen?
A lot worse than I originally thought, Gregg. It certainly has done a lot of damage to our city, and the city that was there is certainly no longer, and we'll be having a lot of work to do over the next few years to get our wonderful city back together again.
We're getting stories of people still trapped in small cavities that are actually text messaging desperately for help. What can you tell us about the rescues?
Yeah, well, the rescues are happening. I was actually at one of them yesterday when a lady was pulled out of a building. She'd been trapped there for over 24 hours. She was actually relatively unhurt and was quite chirpy and talking to the rescuers as it happened for quite some time. But she was in a very small cavity underneath the table that she had got under during the earthquake. And so that was wonderful to see her coming out. But unfortunately, there's still a lot of people missing, and I don't know how many more of those wonderful rescues we'll be able to have.
How much of Christchurch is without electricity and water?
Still around about 50% is without electricity, and probably around 70 to 80%, I believe, is without water. It's happened at 5 in the morning here now. I went to bed about 3-4 hours ago, and that was the latest that I heard then.
All right. Barry Corbett, Christchurch City Councilor, best of luck to you, sir. Our thoughts and prayers are with everybody there in Christchurch. Thank you.